In 2018, Charlotte Kangume's left lower leg was amputated after an accident. She clearly recalls the 26th of January 2018, a day she encountered an accident that turned her life around.
We were coming from a party with my friends and we were dropping one of my friends home when our car got stuck in a trench. So I stood aside so that they can push the car. And when they did so, someone who had just parked their car on the side came to help us. So all he had to do was accelerate a little bit for the car to come out of that trench. But he overstepped on the accelerator, the car jumped out and straight into me. My leg was doing fine. I had just gotten a simple fracture in the knee. But later, I underwent surgery. They put in plates and I was learning to use crutches. I was getting better. And then later, my health deteriorated and my leg started turning black. So when it starts turning black, they take me in again for surgery and they realize there's a very big nerve behind the knee that was cut, so there was no circulation anymore. That's why the leg was turning black. And I ended up getting gangrene. So when I got gangrene, they informed us that the only way for us to stop the spread of the gangrene was to amputate.
Charlotte explains that after a number of surgeries, her leg worsened, and due to the infection, the doctor suggested an amputation, something that completely shattered her at the moment.
So I told the doctor, I would like to know more about this, so please give me time. I was like, we can only give you 48 hours. Otherwise, if you don't consent, we're going to just have to do it ourselves without your consent.
She explains her healing process and how she was able to cope and find hope amid the trying times.
So after the amputation, immediately after I got out of surgery, I kept like asking for my mom. Because then it had hit me that, oh wait, I've lost my leg. But I hadn't yet felt it, I didn't even touch. Then I feel my leg itching. So I keep telling them, please help me scratch my leg. I can't reach it. And my friends are like, is she okay? Has she gone mental? And I'm like, no, scratch it. So my friend Jojo is like, okay, let me scratch it. Which leg do you want me to scratch? And I'm like, this one. So I'm pointing on this one. They have just amputated. And then that's when I learned that there's something called a phantom limb. So your brain is still communicating to the leg even if it has gone off.
Just like Charlotte, on the 30th of May 2021, Sonia Choshaba, while on a border, encountered a fatal accident that left her leg crushed. The doctors suggested an amputation was the only way she could be saved. This is her story.
I was on a border. It was a terrible accident. I was immediately rushed to the hospital, to Mulago, because I was bleeding, I was overbleeding. So they took me to Mulago in a police vehicle, you know, putting it down under the chairs. So at first, I thought there is a metal in my leg that they are going to remove when I was going to the theater. But when I reached the doorway, the doctor was like, my leg is dead. They have to cut it.
The victims confirm that amputation can change one's life, but also reassure that with help and support, one can be able to overcome the situation.
When I got an accident, I found that they had opened on my tummy, like it is where I would pass out from. So those bags, each bag was 10,000. I used colostomy bags for almost 2 years. I was passing out from besides my tummy. I wasn't going to the toilet, and it was stressing. Imagine going out and you're carrying a colostomy bag with poo. It was really stressing.
One day I fell a lot because I kept forgetting I don't have a leg. Because that first month, I don't want to say first month, I think the first 2 months, there are many times you forget you don't have a leg. Like when you're waking up, when you're doing other things, you keep forgetting. When at the times I wanted to hang the curtain, in my bedroom, and then I would still forget that I don't have a leg, and then I find myself down.
Dr. Ekure John, the orthopedic surgeon, explains reasons an amputation may be necessary.
What are the reasons, or what will lead to a doctor taking off your limb? Limbs will be taken out if, one, they are dangerous. Dangerous means if the limb is left in your body, as part of your body, it can end up killing you. So what makes a limb dangerous? If you have infection that is uncontrolled, infections such as those like we call gas gangrene, they are bacteria which produce gas and kill tissues. Those ones can keep progressing, like from the foot towards the thigh. So if it continues moving that way, it will kill you. So for that reason, the way to save your life is for a doctor to remove that part which is dangerous. It can also be dangerous if there is a cancer that has started from your leg or from the foot and is going to spread through the blood vessels or directly eating up the tissues. So the only way to stop it is also through taking out that limb. So amputations can also be done if a leg is dead by itself. It can die as a result of a motor vehicle crash. It has crushed it, it's rotting away. So the best way to do to help you is by removing that leg. There are also diseases that can cause reduced blood supply to the leg. Diseases such as diabetes affect the blood vessels. They make them narrow, and the poor blood supply to the foot or to the leg will lead, or to the hand, will lead to slow death of that particular part of the body.
So some people, when they get cellulitis, they say taro. And then they go with the taro, and then they go into masqueraders who think they are treating. Before you know it, the infection has spread from the tissue, it has gone to the bones, and you basically can't do anything for that leg apart from cut it off.
The spokesperson of Traffic Police and Road Safety, Michael Kananura, acknowledges that there is a rise in road crashes and is the reason why they started operations. He mentions some of the black spots where these accidents normally happen.
The leading causes of removal of a limb are mainly due to traumatic injuries. And here the leading trauma we are having is road traffic injuries. As Ministry of Health, we undertake steps first in focus to trauma to ensure that people get care as quickly as possible to prevent them from getting the amputation in the first place. Because if you're on the road and you are injured, that first care you get can help you to prevent that limb from dying off or from being removed because it is no longer able to function. So we are training first responders to try to help in case an accident occurs somewhere and someone is injured. These people can be able to support. We have also established the highway response ambulance vehicles, which can be reached using common numbers in order for them to run and provide professional care at the scene and also during transportation to hospital.
We have come up to pattern with our other stakeholders, that is the Ministry of Health, Ministry of Works and Transport, and UNLA. And we are launching Fika Salama Extra, which is putting emphasis on sensitizations across the country, reaching every part of the country, reaching everywhere, in markets, to riders, to motorists, to pedicyclists, to pedestrians, and schools.
Living as an amputee is a life-changing experience. However, Charlotte and Sonia have advised other victims not to be limited and defined by their past experiences.
The biggest issue was the emotional trauma, and very many of my friends who are amputees have gone through stigma in their communities, in their families, where people are now finding them, like, they keep telling them, you're going to be making us money, which is not the truth. Because all I need is to first heal. Yes, the first weeks I might need your help, but then after healing, I can go back home. Sorry, I can go back to work. I can start doing the things I like to do. I can start making money. So it's not that every time someone loses a leg or gets a disability, that they're going to be beggars, no? So accessibility is one of the major things we face, even washrooms, because I can't squat, so the only washrooms I can use are sit-on washrooms.
The day I got an accident, I didn't know that that will happen. In my life, I'd never thought of Sonia getting an accident. And sometimes I sit and I'm like, God, is this the Sonia I knew? On one leg.
Doctors say amputees go through a life-changing event that greatly alters their self-image, identity, and overall quality of life. While the physical aspect is the most visible change, the emotional and mental impact of amputation cannot be overlooked. However, not all hope is lost. Coping mechanisms such as therapy, amputee support groups, and self-care can help them adjust to their new life after amputation. Report compiled by John Mosenze for the news.